So, here we are. Next dev stream. And this stream, we were looking the Space Combat Kit. And in this Space Combat Kit, I've bought it for a while in an asset store that was on a sale. You can wait when you not have for a sale, and every sale you get it for 50% discount. Yeah. So what will we do in this stream? So I see the problem is what some people have and what the people have write me after I starting the next video was how I can make a third person controller and can go into it. So I found on the site from the author from the Space Combat kit on Vimeo a little tutorial, but I think we can make it other, and this tutorial is that use player and vector. That is what we are not using. We will create a simple character controller. You see it here. That is the first. In the main camera, we use OT's main camera. You see I have here a post-processing layer at the moment in it. This was for my planet video. So, but for now, let's see what we will doing. Let's make a maximize here. So here we are, that is my little astronaut, that is my spaceship, and you see here we are, have our enemies. Let's go into it. So here we are, we can shoot it. Can starting for flying, shooting, we can change the view. And we can shoot some rockets. And yeah, you can fly around a little bit. The Space Combat Kit have a really, really cool controls. The ship fly really cool. I like it. It's a little bit like the old game Freelancer. So we can strafe, you see, forward, backward, strafe a little bit, forward. And we can roll when I press A. Or cool. You see we rolling thunder. Yeah, left mouse key is for shooting here, and for the right I shoot the rockets. And on the tab you can make a boost. Yes. So that's it. And the goal of this stream is we will create a controller, we will create our own spaceship so we can get into it. And yes, we use the components from that. And yeah, that is what we were doing here. So, wait, I have forget something. Wait, I must activate the chat channel. Then I cannot see when somebody write me. Wait a little moment. Back again, and yeah, so I can see and somebody will writing something in a chat so I can see it. Okay, with what we will start, let me think. Okay, at the first is we going here to the Space Combat Kit, that's here, and I make it a little here, the Space Combat Kit. Go in the Space Combat Kit folder. We have here demos. We're looking for scenes, main scenes, and let me take a look here. And we have here the scene multi vehicles. Yeah, that is the first what we need. We put it here into it. Then we create a empty and we call all stuff from scene, yes. So and in this I copy this all, put it in, and then we remove the scene, don't save. And now I can make here that's all us disabling. And you see we are here, and now when I press start. Oh. So we are here, and here in this we have the first person with a little gun here into we can shoot on it. Yeah, you see some, and we can make damage with this gun, and we can go here into it, and we can start with this fighter, and I can use my controller, my Xbox controller for it. I can shooting around, can flying. Very cool. And that is what we are what we are need here. So we make this off. So and let's take a look. So we have here the chips. The next is here this the turrets that can be disabled. That is not what we are needing. And that is okay. So then we have here the player input system. That is the next what we are not need. We make this off. Let me see. Yeah, that can be off. The next is the first person character. That can be off. So we have here only our fighter. Yeah. So the next is what we are will doing. At the first, I will disable my controller. I think that's better when we make it with the keyboard. So at the first we create a new camera. Yeah, that is the first what we will are doing here, and we call this main camera. So we give it a tag, main camera, and yeah, that's it. And then we create here FSM from Playmaker. So here and set cam. And here we make it a finish, hold the left control, click on it, then you get finish, or you can add transition finished. So, and we make a next stat. So into it, we go into actions, the Playmaker actions, you can go in here in action browser when you had not have. Set game object. And we can put here our main camera in it, every frame, and here global, you can make a new global variable, I have do it before, and that is main camera, yes, global main camera, so, or you make new global variable, type main camera into, and create a variable, and you have it here. So that is the first step for our main camera. The next step is, we're looking for camera controller, that is from OT. Let me see, here is it, and as next, yeah, okay, that is it, and as the next, we looking for a new game object here, and we call it player, and so let's take a look, now you can take your character here, what character you ever you want. So for me is this guy here, the male space suit. I have to put the link in the description. For years you have getting this guy on a Unity asset store for 10 buckets, yeah, but at the moment this guy is not more on an asset store, so you can only buy this guy on Ziggy Trader. But the problem is, it's cost $100, and I think that's too much. Yeah, that's really, really too much for this guy here. So. As next. If you put here the T-pose, you put your character, whatever you have, and we bring it under the player here, yes. Then we're going on unpack prefab. Completely, that is a prefab for me. You must look on your character what it is, and I call it animator model, yeah. Or player model, whatever you want. And at the next, we create here a new animation controller. I make it player, and that is for Tooch. And this controller you found on my channel. We put here this player Tooch, what we are have creating, the animator controller, we put it in. This tutorial to create a simple character and third person for beginner you found on my channel the video for it. So, but let's going into. So we have here this, the animator. So, and I make here the new stat and I'm looking for the idol. So I use from Kobold the Animation Pro set. So take here this. I make a foot IK on, and when I will take a look how it looks, I can put my guy here into it, and when I play, I see it. Okay. Okay, so this is the first. The next, we create empty under the player and call it import stuff. Import stuff. So, and under this, we create a second empty game object and I call it import source. That is for our main camera. Looking here, import. Unity input source. At the moment we have here the right mouse, we make it none. And yeah, that is this. We can go into our main camera. We have here say find the input source by yourself. That's okay. The anchor is here our player. And that is we need a third person style. We click it on it and he create that for us. And so we have here other camera under it. I don't know why we have it. Let me see here. We don't need it. We can delete it. So we have here this. We can go and advance it and we make third person fix it. Follow is when the player going a little bit around and something, the camera will follow us. That is not what we want. Okay. So let me go into my main camera settings here and to see what I can do here. And I have the anchor offset from 1.5, so that is the high. How high will the camera working? So you can test it. I make not maximize. So we are here, standing at the moment in the air. And, but I can going around with my camera. That's good. I open this for the moment. I think we make the fighter off. We have here the floor, it's okay. We make this off, that will be easier for us to create something. We make this off, and only the directional light and the floor will be on and the crates. And for now we're going back to our main camera, for a player, sorry, not main camera, we put it down here. So. And we bring it down, stand here, it's okay. And now we take a look for the main camera. So, and now at the moment at the left mouse key, when I press it, I can rotate the camera. That is not what I want. Going to import stuff and set here none again. And then takes a look on it. We have here the distance and the high. And the high I have 1.5. Yeah. And I have a distance from 3.5. Okay. So let's take a look. Yeah. Looks good. But let give us other. Give me this skybox, please. Thank you. And yeah. As next, we have now this. We have here this, and now we can give our camera here. You see, I have here the post processing and the layer. It's only for testing, that is not for final here. But we're looking for post processing layer. I will make everything. That is not the right way to use it, but for us here for testing, that's okay. Yeah. And for volume, it's global. That is important. And let me see. That's all my stuff here, and we have this. And let's make it look a little bit more, yeah, like it. So we can going on lighting. Generate a new light map first. So, okay, we have this into it. We have here the direction light. We can make it as sun at the moment. And let's see. Going on maximize. So, and here that is. But at the moment, we can nothing do with our guy here. That is the next what people are changing. So let's go in on the player and we give him some Playmaker FSMs. The first will be the player prefs. And we're going on edit and give it a new stat. Transition is finished, going to this stat. And as first set game object. That's right. Now the new global variable that you are must creating is for the player. We bring player here. I have created before for my project. You create it as global, and then you put your player here and make it every frame. So we have this at first, and the next is we're looking for the get axis vector. That's here. So we have here our axis, we have here a multiply, and we have a relative to. Relative to will our main camera store vector. You make a new global variable here and call it player vector, please. And the same for the store magnitude, make a new global variable and call it input magnitude here. Yeah. So that is what we are needing here. And I think we take this here, this 4. So going back here and player prefs and pass the multiplier to 4, yeah. So we're using here for this is a simple character controller, yeah. That is nothing special what we have here. You see on my channel I have creating a third person game series tutorial for third person. But I think for a space game will be better when you are floating here in the air, and when you are you need jumping and gravity and something like this, it's better when you create a controller with a rigid body. Yeah. So, but our goal is going into the ship and flying with the ship and nothing more. Don't planet landing and something. So, okay. We have this creating and now we need another and we call it look at. And we're going into it and we're looking for a smooth look at direction here. And at the first is the target direction is our player vector. That is what we are creating here in the player prefs. That is nothing imported. Here we make 8 don't late update. So let me see here and to my it's the same, you see it, yeah. So and with that. So we have here and I can, you see when I press the VSD keys or the arrow keys, our character will look into our input, yeah? Okay, so then we copy or we creating going player at character controller. Yeah, this character controller, we need this for steering our character here. And we need this for collision. Yeah, so our player will get collisions. So, and I copy this settings here and I talk later to you what it is. So pass it here, I make gizmos on and you see here that is our collider or capsule collider, you see it here. So we have here a slop limit, a step offset, that too can be you must not change it. The skin white, that must be changed. That must from 0.01, I think, must to 0.0001. The minimum move distance, it's okay, you must not changing. Here is the high, the center high from this capsule. So when you see I put this up, you see this will changing it. Center high, make it to 1. If here the radius, how big is it? So when I make 0.6, hello gamer system, welcome on board. Yeah, and you see it here, that's it. Yeah, you see that is the radius from it, that will be, yeah, make it the radius of it. Yeah, so but we make 0.3 and the high is how high will our capsule. Yeah, and then I make 3. You see, we have here and here that is the high from it. Not the high point, the high point, the center point is 1 and that is the other. Okay, but we will this using. Okay, so we have look at, we have this, but we need, the problem is from the character controller have no self. Have no self gravity. We must create gravity for it. So, let me see. We create a new FSM for it and we call it gravity. And you can see it here that is gravity. And that is really easy. We make a fluid subtract 9.8. That is the settings from Unity, the standard settings. So we're looking here for the physics, and we have here, this is the gravity. That is the standard gravity from Unity, and that is -9.81. So, and that is what we will creating. I copy this as first. So we're going into it here. And the first is we need a flute subtract. We're looking here, create a new global variable and call it gravity. And put this into it. And the next is the flute clamp. That is minus 9.81. So get back to our guy here. So here we make every frame per second. Then we make flute clamp. So that is gravity. That is what we are creating here, our global mixes, and we make 20. Yeah, that is the home max our player can befall. Yeah, and that's okay. I think that's okay. And make it every frame. We'll take a look. Yep, every frame. That's okay. The next is we're going back to our animator from here. Our guy. Let me see how it is here. The animator model. And here we will create Playmaker FSM and call animator model. Yeah. So we're going into it, and we're looking here for get. Set game object, and the next global variable what you are creating is the animator model here, and this here will this every frame. So then we're going in our animator here. At the moment we have only the idle. Let's call it idle. So as next we create a new empty object here, looking for the walk forward. Walk forward loop here. So on my beginner tutorial on my channel you found a link for animation pack what's for free. That's from Mixyamo. Or you can take your animation from Mixyamo or use your own animation, whatever you want. But you must put it here into it. So that is our walk. Then we make a transition from idle to walk and back again. And the next is we must create the first parameter. We make a flute parameter, call it input magnitude. Yeah, that is what we are need here. And we make here on a plus icon, call input magnitude will be greater as 0.1 and has exit time will be setting off. And then the next is less. Yeah, make it less. And it's less as 0.1, go back to idle. And has exit time off. Yeah. So that is the first, this two, and the next will be the first run. Run forward loop here. That is a running animation, so I forget here, foot IK must be on. And for that we create a bool and that call run. So we make here transition and we make here transition and we make it transition to idle. So what will we are doing when we are in walking and the player press the left shift key for running. So we make here run, it's true. Then we were going in the run animation. Yeah, so let's call it run here. So when the player not more hold the left shift key, then he will going back to walk. So that is run is false. So but is what is when the player nothing will pressing, that will going to idle. And we make here input magnitude is less as 0.1. And we need a other condition, and this will be run is false. Yeah, then he going back to idle, and we must create here after run is fails, input magnitude is greater as 0.1. So Unity must understand what the animator must do to get in this state. Yeah. Okay, that is finished here. Our animation, little animation tree here. Yeah, nothing special. That is a little start. So as next is the next Playmaker FSM, and we need a character motor. So that's here, And let us see here. That is the movement motor, or I call it movement motor. I think that's the better name as character motor. Movement motor, okay. So we have here, the first is we break up our vector 3. What we getting from the player prefs is the player vector that we will break up. We store this X and the Z. That is the first what we are doing. Let's going here. Get. So. Get vector this. And we take here the player vector. Make a new variable that is X. And the next is Z, and that will be every frame. That is the first what we are doing. We break off our vector what we are getting from the input vector from here. Yeah, the get access vector here, that is the store vector from the input. That will be break up. Yeah, that will break up to get the X and the Z. Then we create a new vector. So let's go in here into our movement motor and we say set X, Y, Z vector. And that we're here the X, the Z, and the globals, the gravity, yeah? So that is the first what we are doing. But let me see. That's important is here vector 3 variable. New variable must not be global access vector. Okay. That's it. So and as the next. We need a vector 3 clamp and the vector multiply. And for this, we're going back to our player. And going here and as first a vector clamp. And we make here a new global, the access vector. And the length will be a new global variable as player clamp. Every frame. And as next, let us see, will be a vector 3 multiply. So going back here to our movement motor, looking for vector 3 multiply, and that is the axis vector, and we will multiply it with a new global. Oh wait, I have here player speed, and here I have other variable. I make it so. So that are two global variables that will be a multiply with it. And the last is we use the controller move with the X vector. Will be moving on a space and that per every second, yeah. So going back here, going here and set controller move. Use owner at right, the axis vector in the world per second. That is at the first. So as next. Then that is the last FSM for our controller, for our simple controller. We create the first here event that call idle. The next is call walk. The next will be run. Yeah, that is the same like what we have here, idle, walk, run. And we will, at the moment, we will bring in the animation on the right place and the controlling. So, we bring here the idle stat, the walk stat, and the last is the run, yes? So, at first, we're looking for a flute compare. So we're looking here for the input magnitude that is from our player prefs here, what we are have creating. So let's see here the input magnitude that is what we are using from the input. The next is 0.1. And when that is less as that, then going back to idle, we copy this, going to idle past this, and here we make none and see when it's greater as 0.1, then going back to walk. Yeah. The next will be a set animator flute. To setting up here our animator flutes. So we call it input. Oh wait, a better solution is double click on it, Control C, copy this. Sometimes some people will writing this from the animator what they are called here wrong, and that is the better way to have here the right names into this. Yeah, that is important. Is a parameter named wrong as this here in the animator and the parameters, then you can not not playing the animation right. So as value we take here the input magnitude and we make it every frame on update. That's okay. We copy this and we pass the action here. So run we make later. So that is that. Now we must set flute value. And looking here for the player speed will be 0. When he is in idle, he cannot walking. We copy this action. We pass the action here and let's looking for the player M clamp and make it 0 again. That's right. We copy this two functions. We pass this here. So let me see what I have juice for values for it. And back again to our animator here and we pass 2.25 and the same is here, and we going here and move to the button and we make the same with Z, move to the button. Yeah, so let's see. So here we are, and at the moment we cannot have no animation. We can walking around, yes, but we have no animations. Why we have no animations? That's really easy. We have here set animator flute and we have make use owner. That's wrong. We must looking for our animator model. That is what we are having setting up here, the variable. So going back to animator and the same problem is here. And now animator model. So. And now. You can walking, but you see this problem, and this problem is really easy to fix. Unity allow you to use root motions, but you can walking, you can create a controller with root motions, but we don't use root motions. Our character will move not by animations. Our character will moving over the character controller. So I make a save here. And so, and now you see we can walking. We can walking around here with our guy, but we cannot run. That is the next what we will are creating. We're looking for get key. And we're looking for the left shift, so you can press the L key. And here is the left shift. And you create a new global variable I have created before, that is run every frame. And then we're looking for bool all true. So that will be when the left shift key is going down. bool. A bool variable will only true or fails, and we have here fails. And when I press it down, it will be true. And then we have here bool all true, the questions. So we're looking for, I make here run every frame, and we take here the run. We're looking for this, and when it's true, then going back here in run. We copy this, pass the action here, and looking for a bool is non-true. Yeah, it's fails. So we're looking for the run, that's from here, and going to walk every frame. So when it's not more, and let's take a look here. So yeah, that's okay. Going here into walk, we copy this, the fruit compare. So when the player is not more pressing everyone as input, he will standing. Yeah, he's going back in idle. As next, we can going to the walk. We copy this to the player speed and the player clamp, the set value, the flute value. We pass the action before here. And let me see what value I have used. Here's my animator 3.25. I copy this value and I press it here 3.5. That's all. So we make a save and we must set up our animator. That is a bool. Looking for set animator bool. Move action to the top. Looking here for our animator model. Call run. It's the same like here. Value is on every frame. Copy this. On walk, pass action before. On walk, the value will be non-true. Copy this, pass the action before, and the same like here. So that is when then he can going to idle, must run false, and the same like here. Run must false, input must greater. Okay, that's it. So let's see. I think that's all what we are needing. So, okay, we can walking here and now we can running. Yeah, so we can run around, or when I move my camera, our model or player model will follow us. Yes. Okay. So that is a simple controller for it. Yeah. So we make 5 minutes pause in the stream. Then I will be right back, and then we looking for the spaceship. Yeah, how can we go enter into the spaceship? That will be next what we are creating, but now we make a little pause. Okay, see you in 5 minutes back here. We'll be right back.
Thank you. suicide lane. Missing exits, I'm glued to the pavement. Between the lines, I keep my gaze straight ahead as the last stop flies by. No more waiting for the gun to fire. No more walking through revolving doors. I've gone around once, and I don't need to go around anymore. It's time to run, break away, forget your sober case. Stop dwelling on empty words. Stop stalling in the doorway. In the doorway. Cancel the cruise control. Switch it in the manual. Don't you wanna feel right again? Don't you wanna feel whole? Don't you wanna feel?
Stop dwelling on empty words. Stop stalling in the doorway.
Brothers on the rise now. Woo! Endless celebrations all in my house. Yeah. Levitating now, I'm super duper fly now. Yeah. London boy, but they see where I reside now. Put the time in while you always yelling time out. And for critic, cause I know I'm coming with it. You were sitting, you were wishing I was handling my business. Yeah. Now I got the ball like Harry Potter playing Quidditch. And my business is humongous, you a thing that happens in there. Damn, man, I'm all bad, yeah, I'm all bad. Working for that whip, yeah, that what you call that. I'ma blow up in the summer, have him yelling fall back. And I've always been ahead. Tell me where they at though. I'm the new pop, all I do is rap though. Yeah. Want me on your song, throw a couple stacks, yo. Woo. Everybody wanna do the same thing. Yup. That's why we ain't on the same page. No. Do my own thing, and I maintain. Woo. Flow like water, so I'm going mainstream. I'm going mainstream. Flow like water, so I'm going mainstream. Yeah, I'm going mainstream. Flow like water, so I'm going mainstream. I'm going mainstream. Mainstream. Flow like water, so I'm going mainstream. Yeah.
second alone, I feel the rain crashing down. All around this empty town, I'm searching for the lost and found. But you don't care, you're unaware. Keep moving like the scars aren't even there. It's in the air, like a blazing flare.
See me flying, never drop down, drop down. Smoking high, am I am not round, I'm not round. No denying what I got now, I got now. Keep an eye out, keep it locked.
I ain't never drop down. Drop down, smoking high, am I am not round. I'm not round, no denying what I got now. I got now, keep an eye out, keep it locked down. Locked down, get too strong. Wanna battle with the beast, bring a few on. The commander and the chief for my crew on. Bullets rattling and whistle at your toque. Never sleep, eyes open, hands clutching on my throat. This a war zone. Yo, this a motherfucking war zone. Impact, yeah, break it open, leaving nothing fucking intact. Hey yo, you been hacked in a safe hiding, but I found it, homie, been cracked. Zone, homie, say you ready and prepare. Take a minute, make them aware. Well, I'll be sneaking in the back, but it's worth the clap. Homie, life ain't fair. Caught me crawling through the mud with a vision saw it clearly. Born a shepherd to these sheep, make them fear me. This a war zone, trashed out, trap house, nothing ever given. Yeah, every day's a blessing, thank the Lord on how I'm living. See me riding with my top down, all cops round, pedal pressing on the gas. I don't think I'll ever stop.
So. I found the problem. I have forget to make enter the ship. Yeah, to make the ship. Or this here as enter. Yeah, that is was the big problem what I have. What was my fault. But you see, a little bug was a long time to fix it. And you see, that's the problem with little bugs. Yeah. So, but it's okay. The problem was this all was in start and not in enter ship. Now I have give this enter ship event. So we make the camera controls on again. Let's make give us all stuff from the scene. We make this on to give us some light. And yeah. So, and I make the plane off. That was for testing. So, but let's see. So, here we are. I maximize it. I'm going here into our point. And then we are sitting in the ship. We can starting. And when I press 1, I going inside. And when I press 2, we going outside. And yeah, that was the problem. I think later in the video, I when the stream is finished, I will looking for for change it. So, and now when we are going down, so we can make for land. But the problem is, when I press E, I cannot go out. That is the next what we are must creating. Yeah, that was the problem. So, for this we're going into the fighter. We have here the exit point. I'm going to my fighter. Mix this all, close it all. We have found a bug. Yay. And let's take a look for the exit point here. And the exit point was not here. Here enter exit bubble, and I have here a spawn point, and here is the exit point, and I have bring the exit point. You see here, when we are getting out, we will a good solution is when you give that exit point a little 3D object, a cube, so to see better how you are. So, and a half of this cube is that the player will stand on ground, so put this into it. So I think we will, when we are exit from the ship, we will are standing here into this. You can make the cube out. So make this on up. And move the exit point to the position as you wish. What is for your the exit point? So here we are. Then we can disable the cube. So Alexi on the exit ship. I copy this. I go in here to the exit point. New playmaker FSM. Exit ship. At the moment it will disabled. When we are on landing, then that will be, we will see we're landing and we see enabled it and see, so we can exit the ship. So for this, we use here a call method and we will set parent the ship cam, we'll disable it and detach the children. We get a position of it from the exit point what we are creating, save it as a test or as exit point, whatever you want. We activate the player and the main camera, and then we position the player to the test point, to exit point. We going here for start fast, we send a event to it, and when we press E again, then get key E or exit chip. Yeah. So, okay. That is what we will doing here. As first, we starting with the call event. Here, going into it and at state, call it exit chip as first. And here on it, we're looking for the game agent and make a script, the call method, and we say exit all vehicles. That is the first what we need. So the next one on it, we can make here the finished. I'm going to Z. And the next what we need is we will bring our camera back, our game camera, the vehicle camera back to it, and we will setting off this camera. So we make set parent as first. So the game object will be our vehicle camera, and the parent will the ship cam holder, and that is the first. Then we will deactivate this. So going back to the exit point. Activate game object. So we're looking here for the vehicle camera. This will deactivate. As next, we will detach. Move it to the bottom. So as next is the player holder here. Here is our camera will holding into it, and our player. So we make activate a game object, and this will be the main camera. Copy this, pass this, and the next is the player. So let's see here, exit point, exit chip. Then we set a position before we take get a position. Okay, so we make this not recursive action, get position, and move it up here. It's a specific, it's the exit point what we are looking, but we can make it as use owner every frame, and make exit point, exit point vector. That's it. So, and set position. So this will be our player to the exit point vector. And here it's in the world, and the other will be in the by itself. So going into this, set position self is right, and here it's world, but I think we don't need every frame, or let me take a look into it. Ah, we take every frame, I think that will be better. So and then he's going back to start. Okay. make this get key down and then finished, and as next send event by name game object FSM specific, and we're looking for the enter exit bubble, looking here for enter the ship, and the event is start fast. So, and I think not every frame. But I will take a look. Yeah. Okay, that's it. And for now is we must, I think we have forgot this we must set property, we must enable it. So back to this, we make this here. So take a look on the exit point. We put it here, set property, and then enable it. So let's make a test. So here we are. So I press E, I'm sitting in the ship, and I press E again. Okay, and not go out of the ship. Why? So don't maximize, and we're looking what is the problem here. So we are here in it. I press E again. That is enabled, that's right. And when I press E. Okay, I come not out. I understand I have forget something. We have forget when we are here into it, we must the same for exit ship. That is here. That we can going out. To control for it. So, and then we copy this past here, and this is exit ship. So, let's see. So, I'm into cat shooting, and when I press E. Oh, wait. Okay, I think we have a problem here. So that is the game agent. Exit all vehicles. Vehicle. Okay, wait, I will disable this. Going in here again. Gamestead hat.
Wir sehen hier ein GameStat-System. I think no. So. Let's go with. So, go into it. And when I press E again, nothing will happen. Okay, that will be disabled. You have here the problem. So wait, have a look. What is the problem here on this? I think that can be a problem. So, going into, press E, and then we stand outside. But the problem is, he fly. Yeah, he fly. The problem is here the call method. This was a problem that was, let me see, here. I think it's better when we make it more down. Let's make it here. Game agent of it. So we are here. No camera render. Okay. And. Can make it here. So going inside, that's okay, and then we are out. Okay, the problem was he has enabled and disabled the vehicle camera. As first was here, as first have say the agent set off all vehicle. But the camera was on this moment, and that is not right. You must bring it here. The best position is on under set position. So, and let's see here. Next test. So we are here into it. Okay, we can start with it. We can fly with our ship around. And then can landing with our ship, and I can press E for going outside, and then I'm here. So the ship cannot more starting. I think in the next stream we will change the chip type, we will change here the color of this. Ah, and I forget something. I guys see in my main camera. My main camera is here, and you see here we use the post processing, but we use other post processing as we use here in the fighter camera. So we can fix it. I'm going to the main camera here, and let's take a look here. For this is a SDK combat, but we use the exit. And now when we make save it and play. So you see here that is the graphic at the moment, and when we are going into it, into our ship, we have the same graphic on all cameras, yeah? So. And then flying around, shooting around. So, yeah, that's it. In the next stream, we will change the weapon. We will change all other model and graphic a little bit. and make our landing high. We will setting up, and we set up later a little animation, so on the upper fighter will going up, the landing foods going up for it. Yeah, that's it. Sorry for it, for the bug what I have created by myself. Yeah, but that is how you can make a third person third person controller and going into the spaceship when you use Space Combat Kit and Playmaker together. And I will bring the space camera here that can you found on the Discord channel from the auto from the Space Combat Kit. He have posted in this. Later I will question him or he can change it why we have a little problem and can see it. When we are here, so let me going into, and the problem is we are sitting now in our cockpit, and when we press the F key, so we can look down, and the problem is you see here, I can rotate every time. Yeah, and the better solution is when we are can going looking up, it's good, down, okay, left, only, or maximum. This and maxi this, yeah, so we need a min max value in this script. And the other problem is when I outside, you see I can look here, but better is when I give the outside look a target position like this to to go into it more like this. So that is for this stream. Now I think after this art stream I will make a little gaming stream after that, and I think in this week I make the next part of our tutorial for the third person controller. And yeah, that's from my side. That is how you can bring it in. I hope that helps you. I will looking for the timeline in the stream later, to make it easier for other people to find the solution. But that's it. So you see how you can create great bugs in your game and see how long you can look to find a little bug what you are creating by yourself and developing. Okay, that's from my side. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for your comments in the live stream. And yeah, see you next time. Bye bye.